everything's made possible using this this camera or this camera phone, the Note 3. I was going to do some 4K video, but was unable to because I forgot to do the settings. So in the next video after this, I'll have some 4K footage for those that have a 4K television. I don't know if any of you have a 4K TV or display, but I'm curious to know what it looks like in the case, in the event that you do, because I'm going to post some 4K content up. For those that don't know what 4K is, it's a very high resolution that makes video look amazing if you have the output for it. I don't know if any of you are techies like me that are really into technology. I love technology. It's one of my things. This is why I like doing editing video. I like, workout tech. I like tech. I love computers. That's a little bit tidbit about me. A note about my workout is that I'm squatting somewhat high. I'm barely hitting parallel. Maybe at a different angle it'll look parallel, but they're kind of high. And I'm learning that squatting to parallel or lower is a little overrated if you can't handle it, meaning handle it as in joints. That means my elbow and my knee. So I'm finding that as long as I'm able to stay healthy, I'm going to work on squatting lower. But I still need that training stimulus. I'm going to sacrifice some depth so that I can put more weight on. So when I squat less than 300 pounds, I'm going to go lower. And when I squat over 300 pounds, I'm going to squat a little higher. And I'm finding this is the best way to mitigate my issues and still gradually build strength. And then, of course, gradually work on my mobility so that I get better and better. So without further ado, let's watch the video. I think planning is a little overrated sometimes. People want to put the perfect plan, like a program or a plan for life, a business plan. And although I see the value in a plan, I actually know for a fact that taking action is actually a lot more valuable. You're going to get more from it and you'll learn from it and you adjust as you go. You ultimately have a main goal of where you want to get to, a strength goal, a powerlifting goal, a business goal, a life goal, a career goal, whatever it may be. And you're focused on trying to get there. And you may have a sense for kind of what you need to do to accomplish these targets, but you're not really following a step-by-step guide. Now, people want to say that you should follow a step-by-step guide, like a program, or follow some sort of framework. And I think that there's, like I said, there's value, and I think that some people should have an idea. But for the most part, no matter what program you follow, especially if you're following a new program, something you've never done before, you're still doing your own program, even though you're following the cube method, because you have to retrofit it for you. And like with life, you're going to have to retrofit your obstacles for you. It's your situations, it's your life. And I think it's so easy to just get caught up with trying to copy other people. There's nobody else out there that's you. There's nobody else out there that's me. And no one has the same circumstances that you have or that I have. And we have to work around it. And one of my main problems, for instance, as I've mentioned a lot, was with my elbow and my knee. And the main thing I wanted to really say and really get the message is that you're going to have to blaze your own path. You learn from me, you learn from other YouTubers, you learn from other people that you work out with, but you're going to have to make your own path because they don't necessarily have your job, they don't have your life. And I think that's what's really important. You have to think for yourself when it comes to training. I think it's so easy to get caught up in kind of like letting the program do the work. Because that's the problem with me when I follow a program. I try to let the program do most of the work. And when you're a beginner, this actually might be a good thing. If you have a tendency of having bad habits of overtraining and doing more than you should and getting hurt, that might actually be a good thing. But eventually, you're going to have to learn from your mistakes. Some people don't. But it's learning from your mistakes that allows you to make faster and better progress. And it doesn't even have to be fast, because if you're consistent, you're going to make progress. If you push yourself, you're going to make progress. If you're focused, you're going to make progress. So if you got these three things in your head, or these few things, you're focused, you push yourself, you're motivated, you're really focused on what you want to do, you know you want this goal, the next step now is not getting hurt. That's how I see it, because I'm pretty motivated. I love training. This is what I live for. I wish I could train more, but if I keep training more, I train too often, I'm going to get hurt. And what happens when you get hurt? You can't train. And it makes it harder and harder to make progress when you're freaking hurt or you have some sort of nagging injury. So the next thing I want to talk about is pain. If you have pain in any part of your body from lifting, you think, you have to realize that pain is a very delayed response to bad movement. And I implore you that if you're going to be lifting for a while and you love this, learn Neumann movement. Learn the way the body moves. Learn what function and dysfunctions are. Search for your problems. I learned the other day, I actually learned this morning about how if your shoulders are back and down, shoulder depression, because you know we always hear people being forward, shoulders too forward. It's actually possible to have your shoulders all the way down to back, because if your shoulders are all the way back and down too much, especially on one side, it makes it difficult to get your hands over your head. It also makes it so that your levator scapula overworks. It makes it so that your traps get weak. It's sort of kind of interesting because it's not very common. And you got to remember that when you're watching this video, maybe you're a powerlifter, you're interested in powerlifting, or maybe you're just, you know, you like watching people lift. I think the thing to realize is that we are a part of a different population of people. You know, we're strength athletes. We love to lift. We sometimes work out too much. We think about working out too much and getting more weight on the barbell. And our problems are specific to us. Or specific to you. And it's important that you understand an idea of kind of how the body works so that you can start to extrapolate problems, because you can't just go to a chiropractor or physical therapist and expect them to fix you, because a lot of the time they deal with mostly sedentary people. They don't deal with athletes. A few professional doctors in any field, chiropractors, massage therapists, deal with high-level athletes. And that's not to say I'm any high-level athlete, but when I get treated and I get help from somebody, I want high-level treatment. And the only way I'm going to get high-level treatment, since I'm not a superstar or a professional athlete, the only way I'm going to be able to do that is if I got to do my own damn homework and learn about it myself. And then learn how to ask the right questions so that I can prevent my issues, get better, get stronger, and keep lifting. Thanks for listening. Click like if you haven't already. Subscribe if you're not a subscriber. See you guys on the next video.